Hello and welcome to this look at the Pixel Chooser in Boris Continuum with me, Ben Brownlee from Boris Effects. Now the Pixel Chooser is a defining feature of the Continuum filters. So let's have a look at how we can use them to define or limit where we apply our effects in creative and interesting ways. The Pixel Chooser is a great way of limiting and refining the areas where we want to actually apply our effect. And even though in Resolve we can do this with secondary color correction within the color page, using the Continuum filters we can do this also within the edit page as well. So if I take a look at my original clip, and we're going to apply a couple of effects to this, specifically to make the area of the fire pit a bit warmer, a bit more stylized, and to then do the opposite in the sky, bring that down, make it look a little bit darker. And the first effect I'm going to use is the BCC two-strip color. And I'll apply this on my clip, open up the OFX, and use the effects browser to find a preset that I like. And I quite like, actually, Summer Sundown. That seems very appropriate. But obviously, this has gone across the entire clip. And there are different ways of being able to mix back and refine where we're actually applying our effect. The first one is Mix with Original. This just mixes the strength back on our effect across the entire clip. The other way of doing this is using the Pixel Chooser Mocha. And if I turn the Pixel Chooser on, I have a number of different presets here to change quickly where things are being applied to. And let's just reset that. But I can also come down to my Pixel Chooser mask and choose a shape that we're interested in. This can either be one of our primitive shapes, like an egg, oval, circle, rectangle, or we can also do gradients as well. And we'll see where those gradients are. I can turn on my view matte mask over here. And I can change things like rotation and distance and where the gradient starts. So now if we use our compare tool, we can see that I'm only actually applying my effect into the sky, which is exactly the opposite of what I wanted to do. So let's, instead of using one of the gradients, let's start using an oval shape instead. Now, when we have the oval shape turned on and our open effects overlay turned on, we can adjust the shape and size of this directly within our viewer. So I can bring this up over like that. And again, if I come up and turn on my view matte mask and turn off my compare tool now, I can adjust things like feathering and even the Pixel Chooser matte intensity just with some sliders down there. If I'm happy with that, then we're all good to go. One of the other things that we can do, though, is we, instead of using a mask, we can also use a mat. If I come down and open up my mat, we can choose what channel we're going to work on, whether we're going to be using the luminance channel, one of the color channels, the inbuilt alpha channel, or we can even pull a key. In this case, I'm going to use one of the color channels. And it's very helpful to turn on my view mat mask at this point. And I can adjust things like the white level and the black level. So now we're only going to be applying our filter to the areas which are white. The areas that are black are going to have none of the filter applied to it, and the areas that are grey are going to have more or less depending on how bright they are. I can also do things like choking this a little bit and blurring it up so we have a nice soft effect. So, and I'll turn my overlays off. We can see we're now only affecting the areas that are lit up by the fire in this bottom little circle around here. Now the nice thing about the Pixel Chooser is we can save that out as a preset on our very own. So I can come into the folder where I want to save it to. This could be a separate shared folder if you're working across a team, or it could be the preset folder within the effect itself. In this case, I'm just going to save it to a random folder and I will call this one Ben Fireside Chat. Save that out. Now that's available to use as a Pixel Chooser preset in any effect that we want. And we can even use these Pixel Chooser in the color page as well. So if I come in and add a new node, let's call this one Fast Film Process and add the Fast Film Process effect over onto my clip. I'll find an effect that I quite like, something that's very blue. Actually, Cool Wash is fine. And I'm going to limit this to mainly the sky. So I come into my Pixel Chooser, turn this on, and I can go down to my presets, load find the folder where I just saved that to, bend Fireside Chat, and it will now apply that to the same area we had. Obviously, I don't want that. I want to apply it to an inverted area. So I'm just going to go to my Pixel Chooser mask and go Invert Mask. So now that affects everything around that's not in this Fireside Chat. And of course, we still have the map being chosen. So if we look at the View Map Mask here, we can see we're excluding the trees and not turning those blue. And as we play our clip back, we end up with our final effect. Now we can go deeper with this. I'm going to come back into the edit page and take a look at my second clip and find an area that's a little bit in focus. There we go. I'm going to apply the BCC Beauty Studio filter to this clip. And what you'll notice is that as soon as we drop this on, something happens to the skin. And the reason that it's only being applied to the skin is because when we apply Beauty Studio, it has Pixel Chooser on by default. So we have a look at our View Map Mask. You can see it's automatically pulling a key based off of these color values. If you want to change these color values, all I have to do is click on them. I can pick a screen color, come onto this one, pick another screen color, hit OK. Let's take a look at that. Now we're selecting much more of the area that we're interested in. And I can come down here, clip the black and the white areas, and try and refine our key as much as possible. There we go. Now, once we've got that in place, we can now come in and change the smoothing so that we're not completely sort of smoothed out. There we go. Let's come to that first frame and adjust this up a little bit. And I can even do color correction using that same Pixel Chooser as well. In this case, I will brighten things up just a little bit. And as I bring the brightness up, I want to bring the saturation down. And we'll take a look at a quick before and after on that. We can see that we don't just have the face isolated here. We're also catching in some of the background. So what I might want to do in this case is create a slightly more complex mask. And I can do that by launching Mocha, because every effect that has the Pixel Chooser option also is able to tap in to a version of Boris Mocha. So I can use this to quickly draw in a shape to isolate out the face. And I'll call this one Face Track. And I'll quickly track this backwards. And this uses Mocha's planar tracker to create a quick and accurate track on this planar movement. And I'll come in and track the last few frames forward. And once we've created this tracking data, we can make adjustments to the shape, and that will just build on top of the tracking that we already have. If I wanted to remove the lips and mouth from this, then we can do that too. I'll just create a new shape over the top, and I'll call this one Mouth Mask, and link this to the face track that I've already got. And again, I can just build on top of that tracking data as I need to. Now to remove this, I'll just set my blend mode to subtract, and I'll exit out. And all of a sudden, if we turn on our View Map Mask, we've now got a combination of our Mocha Mask plus the key. And of course, I can feather out the Mocha Mask as I need to, and maybe even make some last refinements to our key. And as you can see, we've limited the effect to our face. So the huge advantages about using Pixel Chooser in DaVinci Resolve are that we can do complex secondaries directly within the edit window, and we can also quickly harness the power of keys and complex track shapes using Boris Mocha in whatever room we are working in. And that's a quick look at Pixel Chooser in DaVinci Resolve. If you found this video useful, then remember to hit the like button. For more ways to master Boris Continuum and Resolve, subscribe to the Boris Effects YouTube channel and check out a range of our other training. If I've missed anything, then please let me know in the comments below. My name is Ben Brownlee from Boris Effects. Thanks for watching.